Hello, Uncold here. In this video, I'll be explaining 3 easy methods to beat a cheater in Ranked Skywars. So make sure to stick to the end so that when you queue a cheater, you will know how to deal with them. Starting it off, I will show you multiple clips of me dealing with cheaters and situations that you might face similarly. In the first clip here, it was a normal game when I used the scout kit. I did the usual strategy of rushing middle as fast as possible when I got added by one of my competitors. Usually, whenever this happens, the opponents want to tell me something that can either be toxic or helpful. In this situation, fortunately, it was useful intel. With the knowledge that you are playing against a cheater, there are multiple things that you can do. You can skybase and run around the map until refill, you can mine diamonds until full diamond armor, or you can become a mole and attempt to obsidian trap the cheater. But unless you're deboof, good luck with that. Of all these options, by far the most efficient method is getting refill, as it greatly reduces your chances of getting knocked into the void and getting much better gear than from islands. However, when you do this, try your absolute hardest to prevent the cheater from getting their own mid chest from refill, as if they successfully obtain mid gear, you will most likely lose. Continuing off of this example, I was distracting the cheater by bow spamming him from a distance to make sure that he wouldn't be able to come to middle. As I mentioned before, if he was able to come to middle, I would have been in trouble. Fortunately, in this game, the cheater wasn't the sharpest tool in the shed, and allowed me to take my sweet time getting the refill chest. This is where I made a stupid mistake. I didn't realize that my inventory was full of gear, so I had to quickly manage my inventory without realizing that the pearls had fallen off the edge. Since I had just gotten a refill, I wanted to test the extent of the cheater's capability. Of course, he was able to hit me from miles away, but with my middle gear I had just obtained, I was able to heal back up and get the pearls that had fallen. Now that I had the pearls, I was able to guarantee myself the next refill's chest, as I can pearl around much faster than the cheater can move. Since I now have all the best mid gear possible, I was ready to fight. I got all my healing ready in my inventory and was ready to win. For the second example, I queued a blatant cheater with all their settings toggled to max. I know because he whooped me in one of the previous games, so I wanted to gain my rating back. I knew exactly what to do, which is to use Magician Kit. Now you may be wondering, why would I choose this? The reason for this is the overpowered instant damage 2 potions that you get. These are the most effective way to defeat a cheater since instant damage potions do a thing called true damage, meaning that no matter what the opponent's gear, it will do 9 HP of damage if landed perfectly. I started heading towards middle. But then, I see the cheater approaching me. My first thought is to run. I start to build up, and his long arms somehow hit me through blocks. But as the god that I am, I did a sick double extension. I throw down my potions. It gets him incredibly low, so I sweep down like a hawk and attack my prey. I was victorious and successful in gaining the rating that he had previously stolen from me. For the last example, I will show you how to beat a cheater when you choose the kit champion. This is another great way to deal with a cheater, as you start with a great sword that can shred enemies' gear. In this example, this was my 1800 rating game, which was at the time my personal rating record, making this a stressful game. Of course, with my luck, I queue a cheater and something else that's very dumb. To deal with this cheater, I decided to go for the head-hitting strategy. This strategy entails you going into a confined space where you create an overhang over your head so that you can crit the person out. This cheater, however, knew that he would not survive if he were to stay with me any longer. He attempted to leave the cave, but as I had previously placed down the blocks, he was in a dilemma. In his panic, he had made a fatal mistake. He boxed himself up like a fish. Since I knew this might happen, I had previously prepared the lava bucket in my hotbar. I placed the bucket of lava on his head and could have obby trapped him, but instead I decided to crit him out. It was a close fight, but I was the victor. As I had just been a cheater, I was confident that I would be able to win this game. I started excitingly looking around for the very last opponent when I saw this. I wasn't sure whether I should be happy or scared, as it is very difficult to deal with a situation like this, as these players play on version 1.14 or above, meaning that they have the ability to swim where I cannot. To deal with this, you must make sure to get both refills and get as many pearls as physically possible so that you can clutch if they knock you off. As you go down the water, make sure to spam blocks around you so that you can get back up. I went with the bow spam approach, as it usually works pretty well, but my aim wasn't the best, so I decided to do the risky play and attempt to remove him from the game. Due to my powerful sword that I had obtained from refill and combining it with my champion sword, I got him down to 6 HP in 3 hits. This definitely scared him, because somehow he missed the water and I won my 1800 game. Here is a bonus, uncut game, where I use the strats demonstrated throughout the video to beat a cheater who is blatantly anti-KBing. If you enjoyed this video, please consider hitting the like button and subscribing, as I wish to hit 30k subs by the end of the year. Thanks.
Subscribe.